I'm Nick Maselko, and today we'll be keying out the families in the order Hemiptera.
Step 1. First check the antennae. If the antennae are shorter than the head and inserted beneath the eyes, then move on to step 2. Generally, these forms of antennae will not be visible from the dorsal view. If the antennae are longer than the head and inserted in front of the eyes, then move on to step 11. These antennae are always visible from the dorsal view. Step 2. If the antennae are shorter than the head and inserted beneath the eyes, next check the beak and front tarsus. If the beak is triangular as opposed to cylindrical, and the front tarsus has a scoop-like formation fringed with rake-like setae, move on to step 3. If the beak is not triangular and the front tarsus is not scoop-like with rake-like setae, then move on to step 4. Step 3. If the beak is triangular and the tarsus has rake-like setae, then next check the scutellum. If the scutellum is exposed, then the family is Micronectidae, the pygmy water boatman. Note, Micronectidae have not yet been recorded in PA, but due to their invasive nature, have been left on this list. If the scutellum is concealed, then the family is Choryxidae, the water boatman. Step 4. If the beak is not triangular and the tarsus lacks rake-like setae, next check the apex of the abdomen. If the apex of the abdomen has respiratory appendages, then move on to step 5. If the apex of the abdomen lacks respiratory appendages, move on to step 6. Step 5. If the apex of the abdomen has respiratory appendages, next check the hind legs. If the hind legs have long setae fitted for swimming, then the family is Belostomatidae, the giant water bugs. Note, this family is not crossed out yet. If the legs do not have long setae fitted for swimming, then the family is Nepidae, the water scorpions. Step 6. If the apex of the abdomen appears to lack respiratory appendages, next check the hind legs. If the hind legs lack fringe-like swimming hairs, then move on to step 7. If the hind legs have fringe-like swimming hairs, jump to step 9. Step 7. If the hind legs lack fringe-like swimming hairs, then next check the front legs. If the front legs are raptorial, then the family is Gelastocoridae, the toad bugs. If the front legs are not raptorial, then the family is Octeridae, the velvet shore bugs. Step 8. If the middle and hind legs have a fringe of swimming hairs, next check the front legs. If the front legs are raptorial, then move on to step 9. If the front legs are slender, then move on to step 10. Step 9. If the front legs are raptorial, next check the rostrum. If the rostrum is short and does not reach the front coccyx, then the family is Narcoridae, the creeping water bugs. If the rostrum is long and reaches the front coccyx, then the family is Belostomatidae, the giant water bugs. Step 10. If the front legs are slender, next check the body type. If the body type is ovoid with all legs similar, then the family is Pleiadae, the pygmy back swimmers. If the body form is elongated with hind legs long and oar-like, then the family is Nautonectidae, the back swimmers. Step 11. If the antennae are long and inserted in front of the eyes, then next check the wing membrane. If the membrane of the wings have 4 or 5 distinct similar cells, then the family is Celdidae, the shore bugs. If the macro is a nymph and lacks wings, instead check the hind coxa. If the hind coxa is large and transverse, then the nymph is Celdidae. If the membrane of the wing lacks distinct cells or the hind coxa is small, then move on to step 12. Step 12. If the membrane lacks distinct cells and the hind coxa is small or not transverse, then next check the claws. If the claws of at least the front tarsus are inserted before the apex, then move on to step 13. If the claws of all the legs are inserted at the tips of the tarsi, then move on to step 14. Step 13. If the claws of the front tarsus are inserted before the apex, then next check the femur. If the hind femur falls short of the apex of the abdomen, then the family is Velidae, the smaller water striders. Double check the metasternum has a pair of lateral scent grooves terminating on the pleural in front of the hind coxa. If the hind femur is long and greatly exceeds the apex of the abdomen, then the family is Geridae, the water striders. Double check that the lateral scent grooves are absent. Step 14. If the claws are inserted at the tip of the tarsi, next check the body and head. If the body and head are elongated, then the family is Hydrometridae, the water measurers. If the body and head are stout, then move on to step 15. Step 15. If the body and head are stout, then next check the tarsi as well as the underside of the head. If the tarsi is too segmented and the bottom of the head has longitudinal channels, then the family is Hebridae, the velvet water bugs. Double check that the back legs do not have spines. If the tarsi is 3-segmented and the bottom of the head does not have longitudinal channels, then the family is Mesovelidae, the water treaders. Double check that the back legs have spines. Have a bugging good day.